Right after the resurrection, our Lord gave a great commission to his first disciples to go and make disciples of all nations, to baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And that same mission is entrusted to all of us today here in our Catholic school at Peoria Notre Dame. That mission continues and thrives to become disciple makers. But first, we have to know and to love and to serve Christ in our own heart and mind. So we're blessed with a campus ministry office to allow that mission to exceed in the hearts and the minds of our students every day, that they choose to follow the one who made them, who knows them, who loves them perfectly, so they can experience on this earth that fullness of the life that they have received in our Lord.
The great thing about our campus ministry program at Peoria Notre Dame High School is that we're able to take the knowledge that we know about the Lord from our theology classes and really put it into action. We're able to encounter him in the sacraments and also serve him in the poorest of the poor and the people around us through our many activities. And ultimately, the goal of campus ministry is to form witnesses of love, to change the culture around us, because it's when we take Christ into our person and we truly allow him to change us and to make us those witnesses of love that we transform the world around us. And that is ultimately the goal of everything that we do, to bring Christ's love to the world through our hearts and our lives. So we invite you to listen to the students of Peoria Notre Dame and all the ways in which campus ministry and everything we do has done precisely that for their lives. Christy has really helped me grow in a lot of different ways in my life through high school.
You get to see much more of yourself grow than what you thought possible.
Before Lumen Christi, I had first thought that God was someone who was just there to pray to, and that's all, and he just listened to me. But it turns out by the end of Lumen Christi, I understood that he was listening and responding.
In Lumen Christi, I found Christ-centered friendships that are really good and they keep me on track. The accountability groups really helped me to remind me to go to adoration and to pray and go to Mass and confession with my friends.
One thing that I like is we had a group text and we'd always text each other and say, hey, you want to go to chapel today? We'll go pray.
So like having peers who are in the club with you and you text each other and say, oh, do you want to go to adoration today? You're not so alone, really, and you're in a group, and it's people supporting you, and it's just really helped me throughout high school.
Get involved in Lumen Christi because it'll definitely bring you closer to God and bring you closer to people that you never thought you'd talk to.
Like, don't be afraid to be proud of your faith and like explore all the opportunities Lumen Christi has to offer.
So small groups have had a really big impact on my faith. We go every Wednesday, we go to Mass, and then we go eat lunch, and then we go to our small group. It's a bunch of guys talking about faith and about life in school or outside of school, and just having conversations generally about what it's like to be a man in society. Before I joined Man Club, before I started small groups, I would never really go to Mass or go to the chapel, but now I go to Mass every Wednesday, and I think about my faith a lot more. And I remember, especially last year, he challenged us to like make good habits, so I started reading my Bible at night more, I started praying more, try to create good habits to grow my faith, and that's really helped me in my journey.
One of the best things about campus ministry is the retreat, as you really get a deeper insight into the relationship that you can have with God, and it makes you really just want to pursue that relationship. And
given me friendships that have with people who have the same ideas as me and who know God's love just as much as I do, and we go through the same experiences.
There's revival and it's spreading like a wildfire in my heart. A Sunday morning.
One of my favorite things that campus ministry has to offer is the March for Life. You get to see like all these people that are not only like praying for you, but also praying for like all these babies who have yet to be born or were killed, and it really changes your life. And it just gives you so much peace personally. I have grown so much since then.
We go and we get to stick up for people who don't have voices. I think it's walking in faith. I mean, you'll see people that are, you know, they hate what you're doing, but you know that it's right.
Like on the March for Life, it's so amazing to see the thousands of people that go to fight for the same thing and fight for life for everyone. Camp really helped me grow in my faith also, because we go down there thinking that we are going to teach these kids so much. It turns out, obviously, they teach us so much more than we ever thought we would teach them. And seeing the things that they go through is a kind of a reminder to me that, like, just the little things that I might get so upset about, like, that's nothing compared to the things that other people go through. If you do the little things and you do them with a smile on your face, it's like giving up your cross to God. It's growing in your relationship with Him. But in the end, it just makes you a better person.
It really changed everything, because like I wasn't really very like very into my faith, I guess you'd say. Doing all of the Catholic activities that we do really changed like my view on the Catholic Church and on my faith. Meeting Mother Adela was probably like the biggest thing that affected me. It was probably like one of the coolest things I've ever gotten to be a part of. So. Clap your hands and
stop your feet till you're fine. Don't be afraid to go into the chapel. I don't really think I took full advantage of that until my junior, senior year at all. The sisters are always there and Father's there, and the chapel is always open. I've never been so grateful to be in an atmosphere where I can go to the chapel whenever I want. And even if you go alone for 10 minutes, like, don't be embarrassed to go in, because it's like, it's so peaceful, and it's just something for you, not for other people to see. So
put yourself out there, do as much as you can. Don't hold yourself back.
Still my joy.